Action.
Did you just type it just then?
Come on, Dan. Take it away.
What are my questions?
I was a bit nervous and somewhat excited to come to China. Didn't really know what to expect.
The people and the lifestyle and the food has been completely different to Australia. But that's made it all the more exciting.
Everything's just completely different to what it is at home. But so far I'm enjoying it.
Quite shy, but when you get to know them, they're quite friendly, so.
Once they found out we were Aussies, which has turned out to be a bit of an asset thus far.
The road rules are pretty much non-existent.
Driving in China is always interesting.
I was led into this bloke's house. He got out his pushy, which was pretty rusty and wobbly, but it was exactly what the doctor ordered. He filled up my bag full of Chinese munchies and I traded him a little teddy koala.
But yeah, it's been really cool.
We've had a pretty amazing time in China so far and we're really tired now.
The Solar Palace is really, really, really clean compared to all the hostels we've been staying in.
Solar Palace has been awesome.
I loved living in the Solar Palace.
And there's lots of people helping us all the time, like there are these people that press the lick buttons when we go up and down, so we don't have to do it ourselves.
There's people in every elevator asking you which floor you need to go to.
I just love this. Feels like camp, and I just love camp, so.
A lot of the boys have got bikes, basketballs, tennis rackets, different sporting equipment. So yeah, the corridor's pretty lively at the moment.
Everyone's like really helpful here.
I've had better beds, but I've had a lot worse.
Everyone's probably already whinged about the beds, so I won't talk about that.
And I made some new friends as well in the volunteers, and they're happy to teach a bit of Chinese and show them a bit of English.
It's been really good. The food's been interesting. I start chewing on this crab claw. It tastes a fair bit like sand. Fair bit just like sort of cartilage as though you're just eating a prawn head. And as I was about to swallow it, she runs back across the room, taps me on the shoulder and says, no, spit it out. And so I'm spitting out this crab claw. Turns out you're meant to squeeze the meat out of the shell or something.
We had chicken liver, which was interesting as well.
It's not very Western.
We've also had cow intestines, duck feet.
It's like a 12-hour food cycle, so I let someone else try it first and then it's good for me to eat, which has been good.
Duck neck. At the Solar Palace tonight, we didn't really know what it was, but there was a sign that said cat ear something or other.
The boys have been eating snake and beetles, which I didn't approve of.
There was a meat pie when we go to Australia with like heaps of gravy on it.
So yeah, it's been an experience so far.
And Pepsi Mountain's pretty good too. It's just like Burger King, it's free refills every day.
Every time it gets slightly hot, the boys feel the need to roll up their shirts and show their bellies off, like the locals do.
Our clothes were stuck on spin for 25 minutes and we thought it was going to catch fire.
Today, when we went to Walmart, Matt Fuller bought a fridge, a hairdryer, I think, wardrobe, and several other expensive appliances.
No flushing toilet paper. The toilet paper goes in a bin, which just freaked everybody out.
He even had the three Chinese helpers from the Solar Decathlon help move all his stuff into the taxi whilst it was raining, so he could just get it all home today.
And yeah, driving like head-on into oncoming traffic when it was completely unnecessary, big highlight.
We just have to get something to do our washing because we'll just burn something down or break something really quickly.
One of the local boys was talking to Jason after the game and said that one of his friends called him and said that there was foreigners playing on our basketball courts and some of them were women.
We are on the eve of construction, except that we're not constructing tomorrow because the ground that we're constructing on is soon to be covered in wet concrete. So that's not a very good foundation for a house. Thursday, hopefully, we're getting started, 7 o'clock down there.